go back to the beginning. Can't control what tomorrow will bring. But I know here in the middle is the place where you promised to be.
All I want Shalom. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this wonderful time that you again gathered us, O God, to study your words. And we ask your Holy Spirit, Father, to infill us. More of you, Lord, and less of us. This is my prayer in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Please turn with me in Matthew 25:31, starting Matthew 25:31 and following. Matthew 25:31 says, "When the Son of Man shall come in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them from one from another, and as a shepherd divided his sheep from the goats. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on the left. Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, Come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world." The title of our study today is The Great Reunion. I prepared 3 points. First, the great reunion with the Lord our God. Number 2, the great reunion with our loved ones. And the great reunion with God's people. In this parable, sheep and goats usually exhibit different behavior. Goats are stubborn and fight with their horns. Sheep are not aggressive and defenseless. Their only defense is to flee. Goats are naturally curious and independent, while sheep tend to be more distant and aloof. Sheep have stronger flocking instinct and become very disturbed if they are separated from the rest of the flock. It is easier to keep sheep inside the fence than goats. The most manifest instinct of sheep is to flock. Christ laid down his life for the sheep, according to John 10:15. It's the flock of God, and we are being referred by the Lord as the sheep of his pasture. The Lord Jesus said in Mark 13:32, "But of the day and the hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels which are in heaven, neither the Son, but the Father." When the Lord comes, he will meet us in the air. But the question is, if the Lord Jesus Christ is God Almighty, why did he not know when he would return? The scripture tells us that the way John presented the Lord Jesus Christ, he presented him as God. And that's the reason why the scripture tells us that the Lord Jesus Christ knows all things. In John 16:30, this is what the Bible says. "Now are we sure that thou knowest all things, and needest not that any man should ask thee. By this we believe that thou camest forth from God." And also in John 21:17, he said unto him the third time, "Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me?" Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, "Lovest thou me?" And he said unto him, "Lord, thou knowest all things. Thou knowest that I love thee." Jesus said unto him, "Feed my sheep." God is all-knowing and omniscient. The Lord Jesus Christ veiled his glory as God, and he chose to occupy the position of a servant. When Christ said he did not know when he would return, he was humbling himself and taking the form of a servant, according to Philippians 2:7-8, in order to pay for our sin. But after he resurrected and is now in heaven, he surely knows all, and that includes the second coming. That's why The Bible says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice. When the Lord come, He is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Now let's talk about the first point, the great reunion with the Lord our God. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 9, a question is being posed here. For what is our hope, or joy, or crown of rejoicing? Aren't even ye in the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ at His coming? My brothers and sisters in the Lord, our blessed hope is the coming of the Lord to meet us in the air. That is our joy in His presence. And we will rejoice forever. In Matthew chapter 13, verse 49, so shall it be at the end of the world, the angels shall come forth and sever the wicked from among the just. Did we read it well? That at the end of the world, meaning the culmination of all things, papadala po ng Diyos ang kanyang mga anghel, God will deploy all His angels and to cut the wicked from among the just, because we are the just. The just shall live by faith, according to the scripture. At makita niyo po sa slide na ito, kukunin ng Panginoon ang kanyang mga anak sa pamagitan ng pagpapadala ng mga anghel, laksa-laksa, at sila po ay sasamahan nila tayo pakakyat doon sa presensya ng Panginoon. Kung naalala niyo, ito pong sinabi ng Panginoong Jesucristo in Luke chapter 10 verse 18, and He said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. So nahulog po si Satanas na katulad ng kinlat mula sa langit. At dito po siya hinulog sa mundong ito. Ngunit, ganun pa man ang himpapawid ay kanya pong sinasako na hindi dapat. Revelation chapter 12 verse 9, and the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the world, the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. This is a future event, not a past event, because the scripture says Satan, that old serpent, when he was cast out from heaven, he was not called an old serpent. Now, because it will take in the future, he is now called the old serpent. Why? He need to be cast out into the earth. Now remember, when the Lord Jesus said, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven in Luke chapter 10 verse 18. According to the Bible in Ephesians chapter 2 verse 2, the devil is the prince of the power of the air. Siya po ang prinsipe ng kapangyarihan ng himpapawid. At ang sabi nga ng nabasa natin na Revelation chapter 12 verse 9, Satan is cast out and all fallen angels into the earth. Maliban po doon sa nakakulong sa impyerno. And Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12, there are spiritual wickedness in high places. Now, mga kapatid, katagpuin tayo ng Panginoon sa himpapawid. God will meet us in the air. We will meet the Lord in the air, according to 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 17. As I told you, Revelation 12:9 is a future event, not a past event, because Satan was called an old serpent. Lucifer, who became Satan, was never called an old serpent before. So, this is the reason why the Lord need to cleanse the air, because we will meet the Lord in the air. He will clear all any spiritual wickedness in high places. Because soon and very soon, we will meet the Lord in the air. When the church is caught up or raptured. Now the question is, are you a goat or a sheep? Because the goat will depart from God's presence eternally, separated and cursed. The sheep will inherit the kingdom of God and will be with the Lord and blessed forever. We are the sheep of His pasture. There will be a great rejoicing in God's presence. Heaven is where we will be with our eternal God and enjoy the fullness of His glory forever. Number two, the great reunion with our loved ones. We will be seeing our loved ones who died. The psalmist wrote in Psalm 45 verse 15, with gladness and rejoicing shall they be brought. They shall enter into the king's palace. So in this parable, the Lord Jesus uses the example of a shepherd who separates his sheep from his goats in order to help us understand what judgment will be like. This is the promise of our Lord Jesus Christ. And He said, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. This is just only computer graphics, and you will find it. It's a beautiful mansion. And God has already prepared it, I believe. And furthermore, the Lord Jesus said, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, and where I am, there you may be also. My brothers and sisters in the Lord, have you read it well? I will come again, says the Lord. I repeat, He promised. And He who promised is faithful. God is faithful. And this is what the Lord Jesus Christ said, I will come again. In Revelation 21 verse 21 it says, and the street of the city was pure gold, as it were transparent glass. There was a story I read. It's about a man that had just died, and the angels took him and said, you're going home to be in the presence of the Lord. And the man said, I have only one request. I want to bring my gold. And it's one big thing. And the angel told him, never mind, let's go. And when they arrived in heaven, the man was amazed because the street of the city of God, was pure gold. And the angel told him, that's the reason why I don't want you to bring that gold of yours, because in heaven, gold are just being used as pavement here. But let's go to another question. Will I know my loved ones in heaven? Makikilala ba natin ang ating mga mahal sa buhay na nauna na doon sa kaharian ng Diyos sa langit? Of course, yes. Because when the Lord Jesus Christ was transfigured, this is what the Bible said in Matthew 17 verse 4. Then answered Peter and said unto Jesus, Lord, it is good for us to be here. If thou wilt, let us make here three tabernacles, one for thee, and one for Moses, and one for Elias. When the Lord Jesus Christ was transfigured in his awesome glory, Peter immediately recognized Moses and Elijah when they appeared despite of so many hundred of years that gone by. Number three, the great reunion with God's people. The scripture says, rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, continuing instant in prayer, Romans 12:12. Soon we will see Adam, Eve, Enoch, Noah, Abraham, Isaac, Israel, Moses, Joshua, Caleb, Gideon, Shamgar, Deborah, Samson, David, Samuel, Solomon, Elijah, Elisha, Ruth, Boaz, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Judah, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, and Malachi. And of course, we will also see the children of Israel according to Revelation 7:5-8. And they are Judah, Reuben, Gad, Asher, Naphtali, Manasseh, Simeon, Levi, Issachar, Zebulun, Joseph, and Benjamin. And also in the New Testament, we will see the apostles according to Acts chapter 1, verse 13. And these are Peter, James, John, Andrew, Philip, Thomas, Bartholomew, Matthew, James, Simon, Jude, or Judas, the brother of James. And the one who replaced Judas, Iscariot, was Paul, the apostle. Well, many will say to you, I thank the Lord God Almighty. All because of his amazing grace that he used you in telling me the gospel of Christ. And that's the reason why I'm here in the kingdom of God. Indeed, you have planted the seed, the word of God, into people's heart, and some of them believe in the Lord Jesus Christ as they repented of their sins. So marami po magsasabi sa inyo, salamat sa Diyos dahil ginamit ka ng Panginoon. At patuloy mo ihasig ang salita ng Diyos sa lahat ng mga tao habang hindi pa bumabalik ang Panginoon. Sabi sa Luke 8:11, the seed is the word of God. Peter wrote this, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible, by the word of God which liveth and abideth forever. 1 Peter 1:23. As Paul said, I have planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the increase. 1 Corinthians 3:6. So ang Diyos pong nagpapatubo. God caused the growth. We just plant the seed, the word of God. We just watered it. Whichever God asked us to do. Now the question is, will people be saved out of fear of God during our present time before we say goodbye to birth pains and say hello to the coming great tribulation? Of course, yes, many people will be saved in our days while we await the coming of the Lord again. Jude chapter 1 verse 23 says, and others saved with fear, pulling them out of the fire, hitting even the garments spotted by the flesh. So people will be saved with fear in these last days. As the Son of Man shall come in great glory, this is what happened in the Old Testament as they praise and worship God. And when all the children of Israel saw how the fire came down and the glory of the Lord upon the house, they bowed themselves with their faces to the ground upon the pavement and worshiped and praised the Lord, saying, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. My brothers and sisters in the Lord, do you need the mercy of God today? Ask. Of course, someday the prophecy of Revelation chapter 4 verse 2 will take place. And this is what John had written. And immediately I was in the spirit, and behold, the throne was set in heaven, and one sat on the throne. Next verse. And he that sat was to look upon like a jasper and a sardine stone. And there was a rainbow round about the throne inside like unto an emerald. Mga kapatid, ang rainbow po doon sa langit ay bilog, hindi po kalahati. At makikita po natin ang Panginoong Diyos natin ang mukhaan pagdating ng panahong ito. Now, the Lord showed us in His Word a glimpse of heaven in chapter 4 and chapter 5. And this is what Revelation chapter 4 verse 4 says. And round about the throne were 24 seats, and upon the seats I saw 24 elders sitting, clothed in white raiment, and they had on their heads crowns of gold. Ito yung binanggit ko po kanina sa slide na 12 children of Israel and the 12 apostles of the New Testament. And furthermore, in verse 11, it says in Revelation 4, Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for Thou hast created all things, and for Thy pleasure they are and they were created. That's the reason why we are created, my brothers and sisters in the Lord, for God's pleasure, according to Revelation 4:11. For Thy pleasure they are and were created. There will be praise and worship in the heavenlies. We will be singing joyfully unto the presence of our Lord and honor Him. In Revelation chapter 5 verse 11, it says, And I behold and I heard the voice of many angels round about the throne, and the beasts and the elders, and the number of them was 10,000 times 10,000 and thousands of thousands. It could be billions upon billions of creatures worshiping the Lord my God. And in the following verse 12, Revelation 5:12, saying with a loud voice, Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing. Yes, my brothers and sisters in the Lord, Jesus, the Lamb of God, will be the center of our worship. Now, you may be asking, what about us? Are we sitting in the heavenlies? Because, you know, when you sit, you're resting. This is what the Lord promised to us. And He is faithful according to His word. In Ephesians chapter 2 verse 6. This is what the word of God says. And had raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. My brothers and sisters, the point here, if you read John 17, we are the love gift of God the Father to His only begotten Son. God is glorified because of what the Lord Jesus Christ did. So, as far as we're concerned, God is pleased to His Son, to Yeshua HaMashiach, to our Lord Jesus Christ, and we, the people of God, called by His name, will be the love gift to Him. Glory to God. And in Revelation 21 verse 3, this is what the Bible says. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and He will dwell with them, and they shall be His people, and God Himself shall be with them and be their God. In this slide you will see the kingdom of God is glorious. And the desire of God that He said many times in the scripture, I will be your God and you shall be my people. And in Revelation 21 verse 4, it says, and God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. Yes, and he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true and faithful. As we conclude our message, the Lord will tell us, as we walk in the aisle of gold, and when we stand before His presence, this is what He's going to say to us. Then shall the King say unto them on His right hand, when He separated the sheep from the goat, come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom preferred for you from the foundation of the world, or before the world began. Praise God. Purihin ang Panginoon. Because there will be a great union. Father, we thank you. To you all the glory, honor, and praise. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we always praise you, adore you. Amen. And amen. Shalom.
Wash me.